Let's get you out to the game, Army and Navy.
The U.S. Military and Naval Academies produce leaders for the heat of battle. A sense of courage and character resounds throughout historic locales from West Point to Annapolis. On the college lacrosse field, two black knights in shining armor set the pace for Army. John Walker and Jim Wagner, double trouble. The two primary trigger men who've helped produce nine consecutive wins, with Darrick and Fullerton providing a force field in goal. The midshipmen of Navy have been running over their nemesis from the north. One season ago, they used their own ground attack to capture a seventh straight triumph. This year, names like Looney, Gill, and Russell face the challenge head on. Army Navy, some dressed in gray, some dressed in blue, and best smashed together on CSTV. Just past high noon, the perfect timing for a showdown of this magnitude. CSTV is thrilled to be back in Annapolis, where Army comes rolling in on a mission against the midshipmen. A very pleasant welcome to you. I'm Joe Beninati. College lacrosse is no different than the rest of the sporting world. Just the mere mention of the word arch rival conjures up memories of amazingly intense games, especially when Army and Navy are fighting for the top of the Patriot League. Army controls its own destiny. Win and they clinch. It's a little more difficult for Navy. They take a giant stride should they win today. Four-time All-American Sheehan Stanwyck joins me this afternoon. And Sheehan, this game's got a lot of national appeal.
Joe, whenever Army meets, it doesn't matter what sport, it's the biggest game for these men. But today, with a number four ranking, a number six ranking, the Patriot League title on the line, the whole nation is watching.
Army doing outstandingly well, best in 20 years, and a high-octane attack duo they have to thank for that.
They definitely do. You have Jim Wagner. This guy is so special. He's got a great quick release. When the defense turns its back, he is going to score. He doesn't need a lot of time or room to do his thing. He just puts the ball in the back of the net. He's accompanied by John Walker. Now, here's the flashy guy. He's got great moves, great skills. All eyes are going to be on him. He is really the difference maker in this attack. Navy's going to have to be all over him today.
Well, the midshipmen come into this one with their spirits soaring. A tremendous rally against Maryland last week. Sheehan, the kind of win that can carry a club a long way.
Joe, this game was a must-win for both teams. It was a season-deciding game. Back and forth, Maryland started it with McGlone, great output from their midfield, that's what they wanted, but Navy answered right back, a goal by Ben Horn. They really just, it was back and forth battle, physical as always.
It was major mood swings for these two teams. A brilliant third quarter set up a frantic finish.
Definitely was. The scoring happened in the third quarter, great quick stick there by Looney. Back and forth, you know, this is where we saw who wanted to win. Joe Walters right here, he scored two from that spot. Great job, they thought they had it in the bag.
The dramatic stage set for Graham Gill.
Graham Gill, he finished off with two right-hand goals. It's a nice power move. He didn't even know how that tying goal went in.
Whenever Army and Navy square off, they say it's like looking in the mirror. Well, these numbers won't lie.
When you look at it, everything seems even. The one difference maker here is the man-down defense. Army has the advantage in that, and this could be the deciding factor in today's game.
Army and Navy, two teams with plenty of players to stand up and salute. When we return, we'll share an exclusive look at the Alumni Classic, Army, Navy, Men of Yesteryear, coming for you on CSTV.
This presentation of NCAA Lacrosse on CSTV is brought to you in part by Lax World. Visit the lacrosse section on CSTV.com to vote for the Lax World Hit of the Week. Lax World, all the gear, all the time.
Last year, over 1 million drivers switched their car insurance to Allstate. To help us find out why, let's ask all-time Jeopardy! Champion Ken Jennings. Ken, would a million people switch to Allstate if it was more expensive?
Those plaques memorialize the contributions of sailors and Marines. One night ago, a new chapter in this rivalry. 5 decades worth of alumni lacrosse players facing off.
When we played, we were pretty fierce rivals. And, you know, if you talk to everybody, anyone here, we hated each other. But I think now that we've graduated and we've been out in the real world, we realize how much we have in common and really how much we're really brothers.
A lot of these guys, they're older than me, and I don't even know them, but I know the names from hearing Coach Mee talk about them, and now I get to put a face to the name. It's pretty neat.
This is the first time we've ever done this, but it's something I wouldn't miss. It's really thrilling to be back here, especially since the last time I scored a goal in a college game was against Navy in 1963. So it's good to get back against Navy again.
Tonight, in the spirit of sportsmanship and battle on the lacrosse field, we remember the true heroes that we are fighting for.
I just got back from Iraq. I was there for 10 months. Yeah, I got a 30 days leave, and it happened that this was in the 30 days. And so it just worked out perfectly. I was really excited to come here and play.
Yeah, well, my feet don't get tired. So my lungs do, though, but not my feet. You know, my situation, I guess, could have been a lot worse than it is now, so I'm just glad that I'm able to get out here, hang out with guys that I haven't seen in a while, you know, get some experiences from some older guys, and it's just an all-around good time.
We've come together for a common purpose to rekindle the rivalry, but more as a friendship, more as a common bond. And we'll go out there. We're gonna smack each other. But when the day is done, you know, we're gonna shake hands, and we're gonna be the best of friends.
The inspirational story of number 21, John Fernandez. Camaraderie, mutual respect, just something to see. Starting lineups for the 2005 rendition coming next.
There are two different roads to get to the 2000.
Bud Light starting lineup on attack. We've told you about Walker and Wagner, but keep your eyes peeled for an impressive freshman named Matt Scheel, who's a very good playmaker. Through the midfield ranks, they are very deep. Jake Couch had the shooting eye last year against Navy. Defensively, the Black Knights will hit you, and Matt Leister is the most physically imposing of that group. Working against the Naval Academy midshipmen, who are under the direction of head coach Richie Meade. Richie Meade, the former assistant at Army back in the early 90s, now in his 11th year as the lead dog in Annapolis. His Bud Light starting lineup goes this way on the attack for the mids. Ben Horn has been scoring goals aplenty. Through the midfield, there is tremendous speed. The midshipmen have a bunch of goal-getters, including Billy Looney, last year's Patriot League Rookie of the Year. Defensively, a lot of guys are ready for the best assignment. Week to week, Mike Felber is one to watch. Sheehan Stanwyck joining me, the Netminders, today as we get set for the opening draw in Annapolis. It'll be Matt Darrick for Army, just back off of an injury, a broken thumb. And at the opposite end, it is going to be Matt Russell, the Netminder of the Year, first-team All-American, Sheehan, and he knows a lot of today's game rests on his shoulders.
Definitely does. His play is going to be huge today. Both these teams want to score, want to win. We're going to see a battle. The first 4 minutes, I think, are going to be the most physical.
Eric Mineo against Chris Pizanka, and early on, illegal procedure will give the ball to Navy. Navy here at home wearing the white jerseys. Coming into play at 8-2, Army at 9-1. Ben Horn back behind the goal. Graham Gill, last week's hero, working with Billy Looney from the top.
These first few possessions are going to be really key for both these teams. There's so much emotion built up, so much intensity all week in practice. They need to take control of their emotions and really make sure they make smart decisions.
Auer stepping out there defensively as Billy Looney hums one wide. Sheehan, they said the first few minutes of this game, with the physical intensity, it becomes savage-like.
Definitely. I remember one of the coaches was saying he wasn't really sure if the players knew there was a ball out there the first couple minutes. They just want to get all the hits out early and make sure, you know, everyone knows that this is Army-Navy playing.
Leister looking to clear, and the helping hand comes from the 22-year-old senior Jeff Auer. And the Black Knights, dressed in black, with their first touch offensively, and it's not a clean one as the ball gets away from high-scoring Jim Wagner. Just getting started from Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium on CSTV. Joe Beninati and Sheehan Stanwyck with you. Navy and Army one more time, and with a lot on the line. As the mids set the clear, Mitch Hendler finds his running mate Mike Felber defensively. Navy staying onside. And Steve Looney A dynamo through the midfield along with Graham Gill. It was the speed of Navy's midfielders that really gave Army trouble one season ago.
Definitely. Midfield is Navy's strength. They've got great speed, and they're most dangerous coming off the faceoff. They are feared by all teams for their ability to get the faceoff, come down, and score.
Both teams were hoping to get transition. In the early stages, we've seen a lot of six-on-six. Gill, good stick check delivered to him, right on time by Torrey Sokol. The ground ball war will be extremely important. The body's starting to fly. Maravito, the freshman, scoops it up. And once again, settles and slows the pace for Navy.
All right, go together.
Army much improved defensively. Their goals against average numbers this year would reflect that. Navy buoyed by the confidence they got and stashing a number of goals against Maryland's Harry Alford one weekend ago.
Last week's win against Maryland for Navy was huge. As we talked about in the open, it was a must-win game for the midshipmen. And going into some of the toughest weeks of their season, they needed to have that confidence.
It was Derek coming up with the first save of the game. Nick Dorr, the senior, scoops it up. Army in the traveling black in a scoreless game now 2.5 minutes old. Gill comes over to lay the wood. She and we're talking about the physicality of this game, and it's been on display.
Right now, you can see, just look at the passion. We've got five people on the ball right here. Great big hit.
So things carry over from last night's alumni game to the present day action. If you missed it at the time of our telecast, 5 decades worth of alumni players from Army and Navy, over 160 guys they got together last night over on the yard. And not that we were keeping score, but Navy prevailed by 4. On the ground, first touch of the day for John Walker, explosive 21-year-old junior from Long Island. Wagner loves his left, and he rips the roof.
Great job by Army, really making that possession so effective. Walker Wagner, that's the duo we've talked about in the open, talked about all season long, so dangerous. Walker's with the ball, all attention's on him. He finds Wagner across the field, makes a defense shift and such a power move. You can see just the defense all over Walker and gets it. Wagner drops his stick low, shoots it high. Great score.
Jim Wagner, when he looks at Matt Russell, he says, you know, he gives and he guesses. He plays a little bit of a guessing game, tries to bait the shooter. And right there, Wagner makes absolutely no mistake. And Army wins the draw. And they have done well when potting the game's first goal. Season ago, it was Navy that jumped out to a 4-1 advantage. Army battled back, and then Navy went on a tremendous 10-goal spree to really take the competitive nature of the game away. Army today in the black comes in as the more highly ranked team at number 4 in the nation. They have won 9 straight. The longest active win streak in the country, along with Johns Hopkins. And as Johns Hopkins prevailed over Maryland an evening ago, another turnover. Richie Mead getting us ready for this weekend's affair was just commenting about the rivalry, the intensity, the passion of these games. And that is one head coach who feels it in the gut.
And you make no mistake about it, you talk to any player on these teams and the coaches, they don't tell you that it's like every other game. This is different, this is special, it's Army-Navy, it's a game they prepared for all season long.
Ben Horn will switch it back up. Bersner is the feeder, Maravito, 40 in the white there on the wing, has been a very, very pleasant surprise, scoring goals as a plebe, as a freshman at the Naval Academy. Midge trailing by 1, nearly 5 minutes old. Gill on the skip pass, and that gets away from Maravito. Army's defense seems to be confusing Navy at the start.
Definitely, they're putting pressure on them, forcing them to make mistakes. They're doing exactly what they've been coached to do. You got to put pressure on Navy, make them force the pass, and right there we saw a turnover happen.
Jack Emmer, the head coach for Army, was bragging about the team's character and senior leadership. This is an Army squad that has 15 seniors in 2005.
And that's 15 seniors that have never beat Navy. They really want to make today their day. It's hard when you play against a team and you lost for seven straight years. You've got that monkey on your back. They want to get it off.
Black Knights in possession, Walker back behind the goal. The defensive assignment for him comes from Mitch Hendler, who is racked up late in the game. Final seconds against Maryland a week ago, but none the worse for wear. As he peeks out against Walker again. Very elusive dodger, John Walker. Given a whack by Hendler, who keeps him at stick's length. Andrew Dow has the freshman, Matt Shield. Shield taking over for Jeff Bryan, the longtime playmaker for the Black Knights. Walker hoping for a sliver of space, and he pumped it wide.
One thing, if you notice what Army's doing behind the goal, the fielding back there is not that great. We've had a lot of rain in Maryland this year, and the dirt, the cleats aren't sticking well to the ground. And what Army's doing is they're changing direction, getting their defenders off foot, and they're really getting a step on them.
1-0 for Army. If you're just tuning in, Jim Wagner with a rocket to the top corner to give the Cadets the advantage. Down the channel comes Brian Green, a 22-year-old senior. Had a couple of goals in last year's loss. Shield there worked over feverishly by Dow. Walker on one hop for Wagner. Off the turf and right to the crease. A little sidewinder went wide. Army coming in at 9-1. From a review standpoint, big wins over Bucknell and Cornell, a team that has gotten hot. Cornell relishing a win over Syracuse recently. And Army is in control in the Patriot League. Should they win today, they clinch the regular season title, and they would host the Patriot League tournament at Mikey Stadium late April, early May. CSTV has the Patriot League final. Army working deliberately.
Great poise by them. They're taking control of the ball, getting some good shots off.
Shield with a step and score. Matt Shield.
Great job by the freshman. He takes it up the left-hand side of the goal. Defenders take his eye off of them. It looks like he was going to just keep on rolling, but he turns his foot and makes a step to goal. See him come around the arc. Makes a quick turn. Shoots it right by. Great job by Shield. Good protection of his stick. Comes around. Great fake. Pulls Russell off the side of the pipe and gets a goal.
Now Richie Mead has to hope Chris Pizanka can win a draw. There's Matt Shield celebrating his 11th on the season. Eric Mineo trying to pop it free. Pizanka wins it off the draw. Looking for some transition. I thought it was interesting, Sheehan, talking with John Walker yesterday. He told me that Matt Shield may be a better dodger than Jeff Bryan ever was as a freshman Shield now, and we just saw him explode by the defender to give Army a 2-0 cushion.
Huge possession here for Navy. They really need to be smart. You know, when you have two quick goals on your defense, on your goalie, you need to make sure you're taking care of the ball on your attacking end and getting the good shots off.
William Wallace, the sophomore, part of that ever deep Navy midfield. Wallace challenged on the outside by Torrey Sokol. Bersner is the playmaker, 7 in the white. Big assist man for the midshipman. Steve Looney will keep it hot straight away. Tommy Wallen on the sweep. Steve Looney face dodge and fires it wide. CSTV would like to extend a very special welcome to the service women and servicemen around the world watching today's game on the American Forces Network. Of course, we appreciate all that you're doing to defend our country. Army and Navy, their annual grudge match on the college lacrosse field continuing with you on CSTV. 2-0 for the Black Knights. With a threat, it's Horn. A step and score! Ben Horn.
Great job by Ben Horn. In those situations, it's very easy to get caught up in the situation. He got the ball. He made sure he did the right thing. He took a couple steps, got himself squared a goal, faked it, and got it in. Great job. They needed that score.
Ben Horn, a man who's had some shoulder troubles in the past, fearlessly going right to the crease there for the put away.
Great pass, shifts the defense across the key crease. Ben Horn gets a step above, goal line extended, fakes low, and then shoots it high.
Army wins the draw. Tony Bozzolo doing the honors, and then the pass gets away. And another near turnover. Uh-oh, there's Wagner in prime scoring plot. A bad and costly turnover, handing it to the wrong man, Jim Wagner, point blank. It's 3-1 Army.
Jim Wagner is lethal in unsettled situations. When the ball is on the ground or off a face-off, he will score. He gets into open space. He's so slippery. Great face-off win. Exactly what Army needs to do. A little scuffle, good turnover. He gets the ground ball and puts it in. He does not need a lot of time or space. Wagner can find the net from anywhere.
That is a lethal left hand. And he just got a gift from Chris Pozanka. Jack Emmer says, thank you very much. Army is shooting very, very effectively and precisely from the outset. They're leading by two, more than halfway home in the opening quarter. Off the draw again, it is Army possession. A season ago, Navy destroyed Army at the face-off X, hoping to have that trend continue today. Army, though, doesn't want to cooperate.
Going into this game, we thought Navy was going to have the edge on face-offs. Army was going to be the underdog. However, they're having early success and really capitalizing on the face-off possessions.
First midfield out there for the Black Knights, Mike Obringer, Justin Bachmeyer, and Chris Larson. See how the face-off story spelled out a season ago and how we have fared so far today. Jake Couch, twin brother Chris, is also on this team, both of them seniors. Good defense on the perimeter. That was Dan Harris doing the job with a short stick for the mids. Shield playing catch with Wagner. Wagner has a pair, Shield has the other for the Black Knights. Ben Horn, the lone tally for Navy. Inside looking for Obringer, it gets away. If you're just tuning in, it's Navy in the white. Dan Harris in possession. Steve Looney, who started this season on a real goal-scoring rampage. He had 5 against Providence, had a 4-goal game against UNC. Hoping to see his offensive game come to life now against arch-rival Army.
Graham Gill had a great game, number 12, against Maryland, hoping to continue his scoring. He struggled a bit in the beginning of the season, but really hit his stride last week, and he's hoping that it'll happen again today.
Coming back to his left there and shooting across his body wide of the goal, backed up by Bersner. Bersner trying to swim against Leister. These two know each other very, very well from their high school days. Steve Looney inverted. Spinning away from Bachmeyer. Up top it comes, Billy Looney with a rocket. Derek will snag that. And we have the first flag of the day. The first penalty in extra man situation.
In the beginning of season, Navy really struggled with their EMO. Lately, they've been having much more success, and they'll look to continue on that. They had great EMO success against Maryland last Friday night.
And in these situations, Army has used a rotational goalie experience with Adam Fullerton, the freshman coming on for Matt Darrick. The left-hander is very, very good at clearing the ball. Of course, he's first got to stop it, and this is his first Army-Navy experience.
It's such a tough position to be in. You're putting a freshman goalie in the cage when you're down a man. Yet he's had phenomenal success, and they're continuing to do it. It's a very interesting move by Jack Emmer.
Inside, bang! A play they worked on in practice all week. Steve Looney taking the feed from Bersner. It's 3-2.
Not a way that Adam Fullerton wants to start his first minutes in goal of the Army-Navy game, but great job by Navy capitalizing on the man up, working behind the goal, finding the open Steve Looney right in front of the cage. Great quick stick.
And doing that against one of the toughest man-down defenses in the nation.
definitely will give them confidence. Bursner, the quarterback of their offense, great feeder, finds Looney right on the crease. That's what they need to do.
We should mention, you know, Fullerton's a guy who took over when Derek was injured, Sheen. Derek hurt his thumb, had it shattered in five, or broken in five different places. And it was Fullerton who came on, started seven straight, set some Army freshman records in the process. So he's not a neophyte by any stretch, but coming in off the bench ice cold in that man down situation, Navy puts one past it. And with another offensive whack getting late in the opening quarter, 3-2 Army. Ben Horn, hawked there defensively by Matt Bowerman. The mids will circle it up. Tommy Wallen working straight away, along with Dwayne Osgood.
Good movement by Navy, giving everyone a touch, making sure everyone feels confident with the ball.
An alley dodge from Osgood, won't fool Auer. Wallen will pull it away from pressure. Taylor Harris's turn. The field is slick in that area, Sheen, and we've seen a number of guys take a tumble. Bursner on a roll dodge.
Great moves by Bursner, switching direction.
It's hard to beat, though, a guy who's about 6'3", 235 pounds, the rangy Matt Leister defensively, number four in the black.
The win there is to not get stripped. You just got to make sure you protect the ball, and then he can feed it off. That's where he's most dangerous, Bursner is, anyhow, from behind the cage feeding.
Morabito working against the short stick of Ben Harrow. Morabito, throughout this season, has been around the goal-scoring lead for the mids. And they're defending him with a short. Morabito just slugs it on through and wide. They fight for it on the end line. Bursner comes away. Wallen, the right-handed sweep. Wallen, one more look. Off the post! A rocket from Morabito that pings the iron. Army has had some difficulty, Sheen, some episodes, they say, clearing the ball this year.
That's one of their main focus going into this game. They really had to make sure that their clear was near perfect against this Navy's rye that's known for being very tough.
Chris Larson in possession. Black jersey, Black Knights on the lead by one with 70 seconds to go in the opening quarter. You look at the goal getters for Army. No surprise to see Wagner already with a pair. There's Matt Russell coordinating the defense. Very active, very animated in his goal crease. Wagner keeps it on the outside away from Felber. Chris Couch on the drive. Under 35 seconds to go, and there's a hold. The flag comes down, and Army should have the extra man situation right here. A few moments ago, she in a near miss for the midshipman and Nick Morabito.
Great job by the freshman. He has had two near misses. It's only a matter of time statistically that he's going to score.
Army and head coach Jack Emmer, the extra man, the man down defense. They like to call those two groups special forces. Have a look. Nearly 38% effective on the season. Late in the opening quarter, they run a little pop play. Keep it moving. Back behind the cage. Chris Larson. Spin, roll inside. That one didn't find a home pass, Russell. This is not a man down situation. It was a loose ball hold. So we continue to play 6-on-6. Great. 2 seconds now, one. Last ditch effort. Score! Does it count? Mitch Hendler sent it on its way. The Navy bench erupts. Does it count? The officials conferring, Matt Derrick doesn't agree, but Mitch Hendler, late in the opening quarter, have a look at it as time runs down.
Great job by Navy getting the ground ball, their defensive end, good clear, moving the ball. Mitch Hendler, not known for his scoring ability, fires a nice bounce shot. I don't think anyone was expecting that.
Mitch Hendler, first defender to be on the All-America team since the year 2000, a year ago, and he caps off an interesting opening quarter with a tally to tie us at three. You don't want to move from your TV set today. Army and Navy going for you from Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. We'll have the second quarter in just a few moments when we get you back to Annapolis on CSTV. More hard hitting, more big scoring.
This presentation of NCAA Lacrosse on CSTV is brought to you by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. And by U.S. Lacrosse, one for all.
Hey, watch this.
What? You want some of this? You like banana?
Yeah. Here, take it, seriously. No! Give me that.
Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real.
Give me that. Come on, give me that.
It's all here.
Have ingrown toenail.
Constipation.
Hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids.
Remove back hair.
That little itch.
Say no to B.O.
Commercials. That's why we keep our heads out the window.
Buddy, it's time to get serious.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Over 120 channels, including commercial-free music. Want radio your way? Ride with the big dog.
Oh, yeah.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Right now, get a Sirius plug-and-play receiver and docking kit for just $119 after rebate.
CSTV.com congratulates our partner, the Baylor Bears, and their fans on an incredible season. You can relive all the excitement of this year's championship run at BaylorBears.com, the ultimate destination for Baylor Bear fans.
Navy 3-3 after one, and Sheehan, as the time was winding down late in the first quarter, something special for Mitch Hendler.
Mitch Hendler, his first career shot and scored. Look at the ball. The rule is it must cross the line before the clock hits zero. You can see clearly, it's a goal.
1/10 of a second.
100% shooting percentage. You got to like that one.
For Mitch Hendler, a guy who's more worried about stopping goals than scoring them. But he'll take that one.
You take gladly. That one. You don't want him to shoot again, though, with the defense. Once you see the long step coming down, occasionally you cheer, but most of the time you just want them to pass off.
Early stages of the second quarter in Annapolis today. Navy, with back-to-back goals, erasing a 3-1 deficit. You look at their goal-getters. Midshipmen like to play games at the midfield with a substitution. It gives a chance for Billy Looney, and that bouncer was off target. Something that Jack Emmer was telling us, Sheehan, he had to be careful of, his teammates and his charges, with those substitution plays. Bersner turns the corner and scores.
Great work by Bersner, losing his defender with his quick feet, does a little stutter step behind the goal and leaves the defender in the dust.
A season ago, it was Navy's attack that was unstoppable. Today, John Bersner hoping to continue that tale, lifting Navy to the advantage.
All right, here's one. You're stranded on the island. Name three things that you want with you.
A beautiful woman, an endless supply of Bud Light, and oh yeah, another beautiful woman.
Hey, Sam.
Mm-hmm.
When are you gonna paint the hut?
Not until he builds the raft.
He said he could build the raft yesterday.
No, he
but
says
I'm gonna tell him when he
God, oh, I got to work on my fantasies.
Bud Light, fresh, smooth, real.
Now this is what I'm talking about.
It's all here.
Do you have ingrown toenail?
Constipation.
Hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids.
Remove back hair.
That little itch.
Say no to B.O.
Commercials. That's why we keep our heads out the window.
Buddy, It's time to get serious.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Over 120 channels, including commercial-free music. Want radio your way? Ride with the big dog.
Oh, yeah.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Right now, get a Sirius plug-and-play receiver and docking kit for just $119 after rebate.
Beautiful but windy day in Annapolis. We remind you, for more information about U.S. lacrosse or to join, why not visit uslacrosse.org. U.S. lacrosse, one for all. On CSTV today, we are enjoying Army-Navy with a score 4-3 for the Naval Academy. Richie Mead, the head coach for the Mids. Jack Emmer for Army. There's Bill, or a version of Bill the Goat. Navy at 8-2. The big win a week ago, Sheehan over Maryland. The key loss, Bucknell is a much improved team this year, and everybody in the Patriot League has found that out.
Definitely. And then today, being a Patriot League, this is going to decide the Patriot League winner. That loss to Bucknell was unfortunate, and now they have to win today if they want to be seeded number one.
Zoom in on the faceoff. Vizzolo, real fire plug at 5'5", 190. Put a hurting on somebody. Ground ball belongs to Looney. He'll rip it right on, and Derek makes the save there on Steve Looney's jump shot. Leister to carry. Derek watching his troops move back ahead on the clear. Matt Derek, one of the captains for this Army team, set a record for saves a season ago and has just become that much better a player. He began his Army career on the JV side. 4-3 for the midshipmen. Black Knights in possession with Walker. Bachmeyer and Obringer coordinating from the top. Numbers showing Navy the slight advantage in terms of shots. They've just pushed forward for their first lead on the day at 4-3. Walker, a little shake and bake. Handler whacking away at him. Down on the ground, it belongs to the midshipman. Felber lost the handle. Wagner drive, split save, and a beauty by Russell.
Great save.
Continuing to chop away. You see the tape on that injured ankle of Matt Russell. He sprained it. He told me he was coming back from doing thermodynamics homework last week before the Maryland game. Stepped into a pothole and turned that ankle. Some doubt whether he would play. Inside, they force feed the crease. Looking for Seth DiNola, the former starting goalie turned long stick midfielder.
What an amazing athlete to be able to do that.
It's really the turning point in Navy's remarkable year. Last season, they won a school record 15 games. Seth DiNola was the starting goalie. Matt Russell beat him out for the position in the third week of the season, if my memory's correct. And from there, Navy vaulted to the top. Graham Gill waiting for help. Billy Looney provides it. They back away from him defensively. Good face dodge there for Ben Horn.
Both teams are having some troubles with their passing. A lot of them are going low towards the attacker's feet. It makes it hard to catch, and when you're going to get up against these type of defenses, you don't want to put the ball on the ground because the ground ball is where the battles are.
Tommy Wallen on the push. They'll reverse the ball. Good sidestep move by Gill, sharp angle, and it came off the head of his cross, out of bounds. 4-3 for Navy, and they've got a real good one protecting that lead in Matt Russell.
Matt Russell, the goalie of the year last year, phenomenal season. He just comes up, makes a great save, actually gets stuck on the ground. Good thing that he's got a hard leg, so that bounced off quite far. They weren't able to rebound the shot.
Midshipman continuing to threaten the Army cage. It was Bursner a moment ago. Now with Horn. Even in full strength, 6-on-6, we have not seen a lot of fast breaks. Not a lot of transition in this game.
Both teams are trying not to really cut down on the transition goals. For Army, they're dangerous. In the transition, that's where they're most lethal, with Walker and Wagner slipping away, getting the open goals. And Navy, everyone knows, it's no secret, off the faceoff, they're most dangerous scoring those goals. So both teams coming into this with defensive plans to cut down on the fast break.
Getting back into the hole, no unsettled situation. Approaching the 5-minute marks of the second quarter, 4-3 for Navy. Good defense turned in by Justin Bachmeyer. Mirabito, 40 in the white for the midshipmen here at home at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. Billy Looney, the 20-year-old sophomore from Silver Spring. Brother Brendan was at the alumni game last night. Last season, the three Loonies were all together on the Navy sideline in lacrosse. Brendan is on his way to South Korea in a couple of weeks. Stationed there for a year in intelligence. Sturdy stick check and takeaway. And as Olbringer works back, we hear the whistle. This is a push against Army, giving Navy the ball. Officials today, Hans Wittelsberger, David Sloan, and Butch West. Quickly, a rip shot from the top. Billy Looney giving Navy a two-goal cushion.
Graham Gill to Billy Looney. This is what we just were talking about, an unsettled situation. Both these teams, they have very good shooters, can get the ball off quickly. Great job. Graham Gill coming down, powering, switches across to Billy Looney, winds up and fires it.
Just a little bit of a screen, too, preventing Matt Derrick from getting a good, clean look at that.
Matt Derrick went completely the opposite way of the ball went. He really got faked out. Good movement of the ball.
Long stick defender Nick Dorr was trying to help, and in some regards, he may have hurt his senior netminder. Ben Harrell will bring it across for Army in the black jerseys. Army's drought approaching 11 minutes. Four unanswered goals for the midshipmen, putting Jack Emmer's troops in a little bit of a hole. 5-3 mids when you're back on CSTV.
Hey, there's some Bud Light.
Hey, how about a Bud Light?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real.
Another Bud Light?
Sure.
It's all here.
Why not have a look at this week's U.S. Lacrosse Coaches of the Week? The top two teams in the nation well represented here. Kelly Amonte Hiller, Northwestern, off to its best start at 13-0. Dave Petromalo with Johns Hopkins, a 9-0 mark. They downed Maryland last night. They scored 11 goals. They got seven of them from freshmen. Seven different goals from freshmen. Kevin Haltney, Paul Rabel, Stephen Pizer, and there's Army's top scoring freshman, Matt Shield.
It's been amazing to me this year about how many freshmen are making such key impacts on teams across the nation. You can look from Duke to Navy to Hopkins. It's everywhere.
Northwestern with that showdown against Penn State. Penn State had already beaten number one Virginia, number one Princeton this year, and the Wildcats rolled them. 14-6, an easy win.
They are starting to prove the reason why they have the number one ranking. They don't have a tough schedule, but they've won the key games they need to win.
We'll see Northwestern in early May on CSTV. Right now, we're enjoying Army and Navy. Men's Division I play, 5-3 for the mids. Chris Larson will turn it on back. Shield comes out as a outlet safety valve. Andrew Dow, the sophomore, watching him for the midshipman. Walker, a skip feed over the top. Chris Couch, no shooting angle. Walker again, marked by Hendler. Off the curl, that one's off the outside of the goal. A quick release, but off the outside of the cage. Russell's outlet is a good one. On strides Clipper Lennon, an academic All-America candidate. Good pass there, and Derrick took the angle away from Ben Horn. Bersner nearly made a strip. Leister tiptoeing the sideline beautifully, and the big man will rumble it across. Matt Leister, there was some thought, Sheehan, that he might be playing football in the fall for Bobby Ross up in Army, but He was telling me he thought it was unlikely they wanted him out in the spring to learn the offense. Walker! Bullseye!
Great job by Walker. Started on the defensive end by Matt Leister. Carried the ball all the way down. Did the smart thing, Joe. He'd pass it off. He's not looking to be the hero. He passed it to those that can score. They got it to their number one scorer, John Walker.
John Walker has a shot next year, Sheen, of breaking the all-time Army goal-scoring record. He has produced from the very moment he stepped onto post in West Point. And this shot is one of the reasons why he is so tough to defend.
He just sets up, cranks, powers it high, even stick side high. Just completely, he has Matt Russell down, his knees are bent, not in position, and Walker fires it right above him.
So Scheel has tallied, Walker has tallied, Wagner is on the board as well. All three attackmen present and accounted for Army.
What Matt Russell does in cage, he's always on his toes, which is what a great goalie is supposed to do. But he crouches low. He's already short in stature. He gets just a little bit low. If he expects it to go down, he's got a long way to get back up to stop those higher shots.
And he plays a little bit old school, Sheen. He plays on a higher arc than most of the younger goalies you're seeing today at the Division I ranks.
He comes out high, which when you're coming down the field, it's definitely going to cut off your angle, which is going to affect a lot of those shooters and why he comes up with some great saves. However, the closer you get, the more you're able to see around him and you can place the ball easier, in my opinion, as attacker coming towards him.
Right now, he's looking at the opposite end of the field and watching Nick Mirabito. A little juke move, trying to get away from the defense of Jeff Auer, and the wrap score. What a solid showing from Mirabito. All the tools.
We're talking about the freshman on a short stick. He delivers back and forth around the crease, getting himself open. He scored his earlier goal doing the same thing. A great crease roll, comes around the left-hand side and fires it in. You can see he moves, gets a defense, a little bit inside roll, turning around. Kurt makes the turn and goes. The defense needs to slide on him. He will take that shot all day long. See, great change of direction, completely loses the defender. He just turns. He actually makes the shot before he looks at the goal. He knows where he's going to shoot. Very hard for Derek to stop that shot.
And Richie Mead will say he doesn't put the hopes and dreams of his lacrosse team from year to year, doesn't rest them on a freshman's shoulder. But that freshman has produced far above expectations. Multiple point games in 9 of the last 10. Navy looking for another. Backside Gill. Face dodge right on in. And Derek slams the door shut.
Great save by Derek. That's going to give him confidence. He needs this. He's a great goalie. But last year when they played Navy, he let 18 goals in. Granted, there was a ton of shots. But still, you can't do that to a good team and expect to win.
Slowing the pace at Scheel. And there's John Walker, son of former NFL wideout Wesley Walker. Oh, a wonderful shot from Bachmeier, catching the far corner. And we've got a shootout in Annapolis.
Great shot. He actually did a little stutter step, which I think made the defense and even Matt Russell just kind of pause and then completed his step to the goal. And again, we see another shot high.
You know, good goaltending can lead to offensive chances. Derek moments ago.
Great shot, but Derek comes up huge. He's waiting for that save. Comes up, makes a great move. You see, right before that, when he was going to goal, he paused for a second, made everyone just kind of get locked. And then you can see he just freezes Russell and is able to fire it the opposite pipe.
Justin Bachmeier, 21-year-old sophomore who got better and better as the season progressed last year. Navy leads the faceoff story. Army's Eric Mineo wins this one. 6-5 for the midshipman. Last spring, it was 18-10 at West Point in favor of the mids. All three attackmen for Navy in that one had hat tricks. Steve Looney pops it ahead. Dan Harris on the fly looking for numbers. He's got it. Fast break. Just missed. Bersner scolding himself for not finding the corner. Gill's hustle earns the ball for Navy. We dip below 6 minutes to go in the opening half. Mids complete their substitution pattern. 6-on-6. Not been a lot of extra man opportunities in this game so far. They've been playing it hard, but they've been playing it clean.
Definitely. And when we talked to the coaches, they said they didn't expect it to be a lot of penalties. For one, you know, they're telling the refs this is going to be physical. It's Army-Navy. But it has been a clean game. There's, you know, the refs are letting the guys play, but they're not being overly aggressive or fouling.
From the top, it's Tommy Wallen. Just one goal for him in the last four games. He was hot early on in Patriot League play. These two teams, Army and Navy, fighting for the Patriot League crown. An Army win would secure it. Defense turned in by E.J. Barrett, 22-year-old senior, oft-injured player his first couple of years on post. Gill, one more look. Billy Looney will slow it down. Army and Navy on CSTV today, along with Sheehan Stanwyck. I'm Joe Beninati, so glad you've tuned in. Derek with another big stop. This time he robbed Ben Horn right on the doorstep.
A huge save, and as an attacker, you know, when you're quick sticking it in, your coaches will tell you, everyone on your teammates will tell you, don't quick stick it in high, especially the goalie stick is high. You got it. Use your wrist, flick it low.
Derek broke his thumb in five places in practice before their Rutgers game back in March, yielded the crease to Adam Fullerton, but now back healthy and playing with a tightly contoured cast on his thumb and playing very, very well. Army in the black, looking to find the equalizer with 4 minutes to go in the half. Behind the cage, it's Shield. Walker next in line. They circle it up for Larson. Good pick play. Wagner hums one high, and this will stay Army ball. Russell again peering through the meshing to set his defense.
Right side.
Running a little ISO play now for Chris Couch. Steps on by Billy Looney. Here comes the double team.
Great defensive slide. It's exactly what Navy wants to do. Great job. They ice it on the short stick, but the long stick was there, right there, to take the ball away.
That was Seth DeNola who timed that beautifully. Billy Looney ventures back into the offensive third for Navy in the white here at home. And John Bersner, very, very underrated. Richie Mead says if this guy was 6'2", he'd be a Division I tailback. Bersner has tremendous moves. Bersner at 5'8", 175, and a demon on the lacrosse field. Gill in possession.
It's been a bit quiet so far, but as we've talked about, he had a great game against Maryland, really got his shooting going in a rhythm.
Steve Looney with Graham Gill, 12 in the white. Next in line, it's Dwayne Osgood, another senior on senior day here in Annapolis. Midshipman trying to go out with a bang against Army. Approaching 2 minutes to go in the opening half on CSTV. A good one between Army and Navy at 6'5". Gill inside. Bersner on the jump shot, just missed. 6'5 Navy, and coming up at the half, we'll be heading back to the field house in New York. A special feature on Navy's netminder, Matt Russell. Plus, we'll peek back to last year's tussle between the Mids and the Black Knights. All that and more coming up at the halftime break. 6'5", and the last guy on the board, Army's midfielder, Justin Bachmeyer. A beautiful shot to bring Army within one. 6-on-6. Navy dealt with Army's zone defense very well last year. Very familiar with it.
Well, they're so familiar. When we were talking to Coach Mead, he said he's been watching tapes of Army since the beginning of the season. He's more familiar with this team than any other team out there. So Navy knows, they both know what they're going to do. This is the game they prepare for all season long. There's not a day that goes by that someone on each campus doesn't say, let's beat Army or beat Navy.
Derek fighting for that ball at the top of the crease. It's a pig pile right there. And the whistles are heard. That becomes a very prized commodity when it's just at the top of the crease.
What?
Yeah, yeah.
And the officials, after a conference, are going to give the ball to Navy. Little over a minute to go in the opening half. 8-2 Midshipmen, 9-1 Black Knights. Bersner for Mirabito on the weak side. Got past a defender, then the shot was blocked. Recovered well. Bersner on the sneak. Horn. Gill next. Little roll dodge. Sharp angle. Mirabito missed it by a whisker.
Great ball movement. It was an awesome way to get Mirabito open, moving the ball around. He had a clear path to goal. Got to give credit to the Army defense on that one.
Army and netminder Matt Darrick will take over. Darrick with 7 saves on his side of the ledger. Final minute of a very eventful opening half. And Army wants to go to the dressing room, tied up if they can strike. Leister corrals. And they didn't get it across midfield in time, did they? They did not. That's a turnover.
Crucial mistake. You can't do this against this Navy team.
Mirabito then trying to accelerate for Horn and got a little ahead of himself and turned it right back over.
About 15 seconds ago, still plenty of time to get a decent shot off. They need to clear the ball. Quick passes, move it over this Navy ride.
Just 6 seconds left in the half.
They're not moving it quick enough to get down there in time.
Wagner on the cradle, some 40 yards from cage, and that should do it for 30 minutes in Annapolis on CSTV. We expected these two teams to be at each other's throats, and they have been. High scoring to this point with Navy on the lead 6-5, and first-team All-American netminder Matt Russell trying to make that lead stand up. We've got plenty for you at the half on CSTV. A feature on Matt Russell, a look back to last year, all that and more, and then we'll get back for some highlights from this hard-hitting and high-scoring affair in just a few moments.
All right. Hey, you guys want a Bud Light?
Oh, yeah.
It's my new Bud Light bot. Check this out. It runs entirely on Bud Light.
I gotta give me one of those.
Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real.
Honey, the Bud Light bot's creeping me out again.
It's all here.
All the baseball you want and then some. MLB Extra Innings from DirecTV. More of your favorite players. More of your favorite teams. And all the pennant races. Up to 60 games each week you won't get if you don't call. MLB Extra Innings from DirecTV.
Whether you're after bass, buckhorn, or big air, we've got all your sports right here. Sports Pack, only from DirecTV. Over 25 specialty and regional sports networks, all for just $12 or less per month. Order Sports Pack now at DirecTV.com or call 1-800-DIRECTV.
This month, DirecTV Freeview takes you behind the scenes of the classic film, Silverado.
It's a big, fat piece of entertainment.
We wanted to make a movie that was optimistic about all the possibilities of the Western.
This 20th anniversary special lets you relive the star-studded film that made Westerns cool again.
It holds up because it's so entertaining.
Catch We'll Be Back behind the scenes of Silverado weekends on Channel 124. Then stay tuned for an exclusive offer for the Silverado Western Collection DVD set.
Welcome to this breakaway at the Fieldhouse. I'm Adam Zucker. For the Navy midshipmen, this season's success and number 6 national ranking have served as a fitting validation of last year's remarkable run to the NCAA title game. A big part of that success has been the stellar play of junior goalie Matt Russell. Recently, CSTV had the opportunity to catch up with the player who gives new meaning to the term All-American.
Mm-hmm.
Matt Russell. This is the Naval Academy. Welcome to my room. I live in a three-man room in Bancroft Hall. It's the largest dormitory in the world. This is my living space. Every room is set up exactly the same. Not too much going on my desk. I've got the Maxim magazines and then the books. Picture the girlfriend. We each have a closet. They're all supposed to be the same. Some are a lot better than others. This is me leaving my room. This is the company Bin Shack. This is when you can come in the middle of the night, grab any food you want. One of my buddies on the football team spent $42 last week.
As we look back to the first half highlights, Sheehan, the netminders were everywhere.
Matt Derrick has already got 7 saves on the day. He has been the difference in goal. Navy's been ripping shots, and he's just been standing strong.
Matt Russell is so keyed in for this game, so on his edge.
He is on his toes, making the key saves when he needs to, stepping up, great kick save right there. Actually left him on the ground for a bit.
Last week it was Mitch Hendler getting clotheslined at the buzzer. The final seconds of that win over Maryland. Today, he scores a big, big goal after getting wiped out last week by Tamburino of the Terps. It was Mitch Hendler on the run late in the first quarter.
An absolutely brutal hit that left him walking slow, but today he was full speed ahead, scoring the first goal of his career.
3-3 after one, 6-5 through two, and the shot story is heavily Navy's way.
You just look at the stats, the one thing that stands out is the shot. Matt Derrick in Army's cage has been coming up big. If Navy starts actually hitting the goal, this could be a different second half.
Pizanka trying to figure out Mineo at the draw in another illegal procedure. This time, it's against Navy in white. So the third quarter begins with Army in possession. Navy has been in cruise control this year when leading at the break. So too for an Army team that has only lost once all year. It's season opener, Sheehan. They dropped a 9-4 decision at the Dome against Syracuse. After that, they have come out the victor 9 straight times.
They've learned early and never looked back. And they are really, they're seasoned to play in these very close games. In practice, they play one goal down all the time. They know how to come back, they know how to fight, and they know how to score when they're under pressure.
That was Obringer testing Matt Russell, who makes the early save in the third quarter to keep it a 6-5 lead. 9 straight wins for the Black Knights in one season, the longest winning streak since 1958. Hendler brings it across. Navy defending its home turf here at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium and dressed in white. Richie Mead concludes his substitutions for Graham Gill. Back behind the goal to the conductor, Bersner. He coordinates everything and makes magic. Sweet music from behind that goal. Gill on the isolation.
Here we go, we see another one of those low passes. There's no excuse for it. At this point in the season, the passes need to be crisp. It just probably is a little bit emotions or just misjudging the pass. But again, it's better to underthrow, especially when you're on the out-of-bounds line, than overthrow and lose possession.
Maybe the guys are chilly, and there is a stiff breeze blowing from the east at about, 15, 20 miles an hour. Does that influence your passing?
It definitely was. I know we're cold. I don't know how cold they are moving around, but it definitely would help you to cause you to tighten up.
Beautiful shot there by Steve Looney to get things started.
Great passing. There's a lot of teamwork going on here on this Navy attack. Moving the ball, finding who's open. Right there you see Army's defense in a huddle. They didn't want to see that goal go in. That was a defensive breakdown.
Steve Looney choosing the alley and then the overhand shot to beat Derrick.
He did a great job, actually shot with his right hand, didn't have much of an angle, and just Matt Derrick didn't see that go in. I think he must have gotten screened, and it just was a great job by Looney, powering through and shooting it right hand.
Back to midfield at the X for the draw. Good scoop there by Pizanka, who is playing with a very badly injured left shoulder. He got wrapped in the Bucknell overtime loss, but has been fighting through the pain. It is 7-5 Navy, and CSTV extends a very special welcome to servicewomen and servicemen around the world watching today's game on the American Forces Network. We appreciate all you're doing to defend our great country today. We're watching future military leaders on the field, Army and Navy colliding in their storied rivalry. Navy trying to win and trying to forge itself to the top spot in the Patriot League. Army controls its own destiny. Should they win, they win the regular season title, they would host the tournament. Navy needs this win and a little bit of help with respect to Holy Cross and Bucknell in the future Patriot League battles. From the top, it's Chris Larson. He had the game winner against Bucknell last week. It came with just 21 ticks left in the fourth quarter.
Nice double team, good switching of fields.
Walker behind the goal. The feed inside, little jump shot, and Russell was ready as Chris Larson was there to test him. Larson's a guy who's bulked up, Sheen, about 30 pounds since he came on to the post at West Point. Russell watching, back come the mids. Bull flight. Harris on the kick. Jump shot, score!
Great score. That is what happens on the fast break with Navy. Their midfield is so fast. They get the ball down at the other end of the field so quickly. Again, we're seeing Army's defense in a huddle, a defensive breakdown. They need to slow the midfield unit down because Navy is so lethal on this. Again, we see the same score, very similar to the last score we saw on Derek, coming down the right-hand side. You can just see a power, great power move up high.
For Nick Morabito, the 19-year-old freshman from upstate New York. Morabito, last week against Maryland, was the first time all season that he did not dent the twine. He's making up for it today. In the big game with Arby, he's got two. And Navy has its largest lead on the afternoon. Ben Horn playing catch with Steve Looney. Ben Horn, the California native, who will be a Navy pilot in the future. That was his service assignment. Found that out in the early fall. Back and forth, these two teams have played today. And this will be a procedure against the mids, giving Matt Derrick and the Army Black Knights the ball back, and away to the races they come. As Army tries to shave into the three-goal deficit. Good stick in the passing lane by Felber. The ricochet. Ground ball for Obringer. Fenced in there in the corner. Obringer trying to work around a pick. Gets help from the senior Ben Harrow. Another defensive midfielder there, Jeff Auer as well, as the Black Knights will try to change it up on the fly. Shield controlling the pace for Army. Walker and Wagner were both a factor in the opening half. Approaching the 5-minute mark in quarter number three with you on CSTV from here in Annapolis. Bachmeier, a beautifully well-placed shot in the second quarter for his lone strike. Here comes Walker. Handler has been in his hip pocket all day, Sheen.
Handler, his assignment was to stay on him and do not leave. Walker is a player that you cannot take your eyes off of. He is too lethal, and his one-on-one skills are as dangerous as anyone out there.
Excellent defensive posture there for Navy. Ward Hackett coming away, looking for a numbers advantage. Morabito surrounded by the black jersey Black Knights. Leister comes out of the pack. Ooh, Graham Gill flattened him with a high hit. And Leister comes back looking for revenge. Obringer snakes his way and calms things down with Wagner. 46 goals last year. He wasn't even all Patriot League. Jim Wagner, who will branch for air defense artillery in the future.
That ball scuff, there's a lot of pushing going on, but the coaches told us in the conference calls earlier this week that refs let the guys play. It's gonna be a battle out there. These are warrior teams, let them go.
On the ground ball, Bowerman, perhaps the most physical of Army's close defenders, just goosed it ahead there. Control belongs to Hendler. Mitch Hendler says, follow me, the third team All-America of a season ago. Picking up Horn in transition.
Take him, Matt. Take him, Matty.
Ben Horn against Bowerman. Leister lining up against Bersner. That was the marquee matchup on the Army defensive half.
Leister, a very physical player, but Bersner's been passing and scoring. He's very dangerous. Leister has not been able to contain him.
Wanting to make a big impact was Leister on the day. Said that Navy won last year's game between the restraining lines. It was Army not being able to slow down the speed. The Midshipmen were one of the fastest teams in the country a year ago. National finalists losing to Syracuse in May in Baltimore.
All of Navy's success, it's great for the sport, but it also, it just fired Army up more so. They kept seeing Navy, the golden children of lacrosse.
Beautiful set play to the inside. All the passing clicking. Ben Horn on the finish as the Midshipmen are finding the answers to Matt Darrick.
Great quick stick by Ben Horn right on the doorstep. Just fires it in. Doesn't take a step. Great move. You can just see, watch it set up. Ben Horn just gets his right hand. Right before he gets hit, he puts himself in a position that he's able to score, puts himself on the other side of the goal, that actually Derek is out of position, open net, wide open for him.
The interesting thing is that Navy, in the first quarter, may have been trying to get into the offense a little too quickly. They seemed at a much more casual, relaxed pace now in quarter number three.
They're definitely taking their patience, probably halftime. They had talking to the coaches. This is their game to win. Right now, they've got a four-goal lead.
Bizanko is looking for another quick connection there with Horn. Bizanko looks to the top. Looney, beautiful face dodge, and he ripped it high. Steve Looney acrobatically trying to lift Navy into double digits. They're on another run. Earlier in the day, they had four goals in succession, now three straight.
We saw in the first half that Navy definitely had the edge in shots taken. Now they're hitting the back of the net. Those shots are going into goal. They're not missing the cage nearly as much in the first half, and that's why we're such a differential in goals scored now.
And Army's already proven they don't need a lot of shots. Against Hofstra, they scored 11 times, Sheehan, on just 23 shots to down the Pride for the first time in 7 years, something they did this campaign. Tangling with Navy today in Annapolis. Horn sneaks, little skip pass. Osgood fires, it scores! Dwayne Osgood.
Great job by Navy, Joe. They're doing just what you said. They're taking their time. They found the right person, a skip pass, shifted the ball from the right-hand side behind the goal all the way to the left hand up top. Great score, a bounce shot. We haven't seen that from Navy except for Mitch Hendler's bounce shot. Great job, the whole defense. Watch the defense run up to Army defense, runs up. Great shot. Dwayne Osgood, nice bouncer.
Matt Darrick had the hot hand early, no pun intended. His hand is injured and broken from earlier in the season. He's just back into action last week against Bucknell. And now, all of a sudden, Navy is starting to find the holes in number three's armor.
Definitely are. And last year, as we mentioned, Navy scored 18 goals on Matt Darrick. You got to know that rips away his confidence a little bit. He had a strong first half, needs to dig deep. He's a great goalkeeper. He can do it.
And any goaltender, though, at this level knows right now these are the most important situations. Darrick knows he needs a big save and he needs one quickly, especially with Navy on the ball and making another run. Billy Looney channeling down the wing. Jeff Costa, another senior there with him. Pair of 23s on the flank. Navy bolting to a five-goal advantage here in the third quarter. Steve Looney keeps it hot. Horn, Bersner, inside for Maravito, and he was rattled by Nick Dorr. It's all Darrick in the crease for Army now.
Very important possession for Army right now. They need to make a good clear, get a good possession down on attack, get everyone settled. A five-goal run by Navy is not what they were looking for in the opening minutes of the second half.
Sixth-ranked Navy coming in with a mark of 8-2. Fourth-ranked Army at 9-1. Unblemished in the Patriot League, but trailing the Mids by five. John Burton with a touch. Seth DiNola squeezing out on him. Brian Green, a 22-year-old senior. In his career against Navy, he's got goals in two of the three clashes. None so far today.
At this point in the game, you want the ball in your top player's stick. We need to see Walker and Wagner with the ball. They need to make it happen.
Army goes to Wagner here as a flag settles down. An extra man situation soon to come. Army in possession, about to go man up. Chris Larson spins in. Matched there well by Clipper Lennon. Big value on this team, Lennon, without all the big accolades for his defensive work. Little roll dodge to the inside. Another flag comes down. And this is going to be a golden opportunity for Army. Two different penalties on this sequence. On CSTV today, we welcome you to Memorial Stadium in Annapolis. Along with Sheehan Stanwyck, I'm Joe Beninati. Navy and Army for the 80th time against one another. A wonderful crowd. Better than 12,000, the most to ever witness an Army-Navy game. Interestingly enough, last year at Mikey Stadium, these two teams set a West Point record for attendance, and they do so today in Annapolis. Two guys in the penalty bench for Navy.
Army.
Harris and DeNola.
Army needs to score on this. You have to take advantage of these opportunities.
6-on-4, Wagner's pass was blocked. Wagner is the gun with that wicked left-handed shot. Straight away, the bouncer off the crossbar. The ricochet sent by Larson. Walker sightseeing inside for Wagner, he scores!
Walker to Wagner, what a great combination. And then you just see, Wagner does not need a lot of time. He's so skilled being able to make the quick catch, barely even cradles, and turns and score. Exactly what Army needs to do in that type of possession.
It is fun to watch Jim Wagner. He gets the ball in his stick, and it is gone in the blink of an eye.
He doesn't. I probably think he's had the ball in the stick only seconds at times he's scored. He just turns. He's so slippery. He gets free. You cannot turn your back on him. Just look. He just curls right around. Defense has no idea. He's wide open, and the goal's in the back of the net.
Just a pure finisher. Scored only 5 goals his freshman year. That was the time when he was being mentored by a great player like Tim Pearson. And has just blossomed into a fantastic goal-getter at Army.
Well, a player like Wagner, what you need someone to be able to feed him. He's great at getting open, so you have to have the skilled feeders, and he's great at getting the loose ball. So, you know, it's really a team effort, but if you can use him well, he really shines.
Army is hungry now, Sheehan. They just won the draw, and now they look to trim down the deficit. Jake Couch, 16 goals last year. His first 2 years with the Black Knights, no goals. But last year, he came to the forefront. Walker gonna isolate from the top. Hendler steps out on him. On the sweep, there's Wagner just missing. That one-time shot again. Wagner used that quick stick to bag 5 goals last year against Maryland in the first round of the NCAA tournament. Army's been an NCAA tourney factor in the last 2 seasons. The best one-loss mark for them at 9-1 in some 20 years. Looking on and hoping to break through Matt Russell and the Navy defense. 10-6 if you're just tuning in. Walker, ripped off from the backside beautifully. That was set up by Hendler. A little pickpocket starts the break and the pass spins DeNola around. Bachmeier sandwiched on the sideline and the officials say Navy ball. Nine straight wins for Army. Navy today entering play, winners of 5 of the last 6. Steve Looney and friends have beaten Army 7 straight, 10 of the last 12. It's a sun-kissed, albeit cold day in Annapolis. Mids trying to warm up here offensively with Horn. Bersner, Mirabito the lefty next in line. Graham Gill, whose dad is a Vietnam vet, a former helicopter pilot who flew for the Army, of all places. William Gill will be here to address an aviation class in a couple of weeks to talk about his experiences during wartime. Numbers coming your way. Navy for these two sides?
Navy doing a nice job of using time as their friend. They've got the lead. They're just working the ball around, waiting for the right opportunity. They're not going to throw it away needlessly.
Mirabito choosing Billy Looney. Looney coming back, wants his right. No shot there. Wallen, Mirabito, and Bersner next in line. Leister staring daggers at Bersner now. Mirabito with a face dodge. Great pass. Bersner, one more. Wallen, drive! And it was Derek getting a chunk of that on the way by. The last Navy goal from practically the same spot, a long bounce shot, came out of the cross of Dwayne Osgood. It's 10-6, just under 90 seconds to go in the third. Bersner, good poke check. And Bowerman, who threw his timing off. And this is going to go back over to Army now, late in quarter number three. Jack Emmer coordinating the clear, and Richie Mead, his former assistant and very, very good friend. Tremendous respect between these two gentlemen. Richie Mead was telling us during the week, it's the toughest game from a competitive standpoint and also from a personal standpoint for him. Trying to beat one of his mentors and the guy who really gave him a chance when he was out of the lacrosse coaching in the early 90s. Under a minute now in quarter three. An inverted midfielder there was Chris Couch. And this is going to go back over to Navy.
Crucial turnover. Army really needed that possession. And this crucial time, you got to go to your goal scorers. Walker and Wagner, they have the experience. They can get the job done. Like we said before, they're the ones that need to step up.
Well, they had half of the goals last year in that 18-10 loss. Walker and Wagner combined for a handful. Today, Wagner has the hat trick. Walker has also signed his name on the score sheet. Navy looking to end a very profitable third quarter for themselves on a high note now. Steve Looney for Horn. Billy Looney, score!
There is Navy's play. We've seen that do that time and time again, and they're having success. They take the ball, they do a nice skip pass, bring the ball, Ben Horn run it over. Great feed to Looney, and then again, they fire from that right-hand side. Matt Derrick and the Army defense have not caught on to this play.
Billy Looney had some big goals in the national semifinals and in the finals last year, and this is an important one right now.
The reason that works so well is that the attacker, the passer, pulls the defense one side. When they skip that pass, the whole defense has to shift, and the shot comes off so quickly, it's very effective. But Navy's done it a couple times now. Army needs to figure it out.
That's the voice of four-time All-American Sheehan Stanwyck. Four-time All-America at Georgetown. She holds every scoring record for the Hoyas. Surveying the Navy offense, which has really clicked in quarter number three. A brilliant frame for the mids. They outscore Army 5-1 in the third session and have now jumped to an 11-6 advantage. The best of Division I lacrosse continues on CSTV. We've got plenty more coming from Navy Marine Corps Memorial. Army and Navy, with Navy dominating the storyline over recent years, and now starting to extend their lead against the Knights.
Do you have ingrown toenail?
Constipation.
Hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids.
Remove back hair.
That little itch.
Say no to B.O.
Commercials. That's why we keep our heads out the window. Buddy, it's time to get serious.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Over 120 channels, including commercial-free music. Want radio your way? Ride with the big dog.
Oh, yeah.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Right now, get a Sirius plug-and-play receiver and docking kit for just $119 after rebate.
Total fitness is heart and mind and body and soul. Total fitness is about total aliveness.
For your total life, only Bally offers a total fitness solution with equipment, nutrition, education, personal training, and supportive community.
When you're totally fit, your power lives beyond the gym.
Results are guaranteed in 30 days or your money back. Call now and become a Bally member for only $19 down and $19 a month. Bally, total fitness for your total life.
It's less about having great abs than a great life.
Call 1-888-212-3600.
With DirecTV Pay-Per-View, you have the best seat in the house. No driving, no lines, no hassle. Just a huge selection of today's top movies ready at the push of a button. Use our first 5 minutes free feature to try before you buy, starting at channel 125. DirecTV Pay-Per-View, always the best seat in the house.
There's the score sliced up by quarter, 11-6 for Navy. And before the game today, a couple of F-18s on loan from Air Station Oceana roaring overhead at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, piloted by Greg Sears and Brent Blackmer. Call signs Mongo and Stretch. Wonder what it's like flying around in the wind. Then again, at that speed, you probably don't feel it at all. Those two guys honored and recognized between quarters three and four. Navy leading in the faceoff battle. Navy leading where it matters most on the big board by five as we roll quarter number four with you on CSTV. Tony Vizzolo gets control for Army. If you're just tuning in, Army in the visiting black. Navy here at home dressed in white. Midshipmen next up for them. They're at Johns Hopkins where they will hope to end a 30-game, yes, I said 30-game losing streak to the Blue Jays. Next in line for Army, they'll travel to Holy Cross for a Patriot League game Tuesday against the Crusaders. Back behind the cage, inside roll, and a beautiful finish for Chris Larson, who's pumped up about it.
Army answered the fourth quarter just like they needed to with a score. Great job coming in. They need to start strong. They're still down by four goals.
Born in Auckland, New Zealand, 22-year-old Chris Larson had a huge goal last week, and he's got one to start momentum now for Army.
This presentation of NCAA Lacrosse on CSTV is brought to you by STX, relentless dedication to the sport.
CSTV.com congratulates our partner, the North Carolina Tar Heels, and their fans on an incredible season. You can relive all the excitement of this year's championship run at TarHeelBlue.com, the ultimate destination for everything Carolina Blue.
Everything college sports, CSTV.
We're back here at Navy Marine Corps Stadium. Navy, number six in the nation, is in the lead, 11-7. Before we went to break, Army came out in the fourth quarter on fire, came up with a much-needed score, just the way they need to do. Chris Larson, who's been stepping up big time, does a great inside roll, very tight moves, puts a goal right past Russell. Exactly what Army needs to do if they want to be back in this game.
And obviously he paid for it at the business end of it, as Richie Meade's defenders came a-running after him.
You know, Joe, when you score, it really doesn't hurt that much, though.
Easy to dust yourself off. Army wins another important faceoff. They are not getting manhandled at the X this year. 11-7 now for Navy, and Matt Russell prepares for this next offensive volley from Army. Richie Meade was saying during the year, and during last year in particular, it was Russell who robbed people, who took away sure goals, and he needs to make more of those big, big saves as the season progresses this year.
He's just very explosive. He's got such quick reactions that when he stuffs you, it looks so much more like a grander save than other goalies. He explodes, and really, it just looks like he really, it's a big impact when he makes those key saves.
And right now, he'll help coordinate the clear. That goals against average is a pristine 5.78. Navy, for long stretches last year, was among the national leaders in goals against average. They continue to be again this year. A couple weeks ago, they were roughed up by Georgetown. They weren't pleased with the way they defended. They took a step in the right direction against Maryland last week. And today, they are trying to keep Army under wraps, protecting a four-goal advantage. Graham Gill ready to move. This Army defense has also picked up and been much improved, although they've been roughed up a tad by Navy today. Jack Emmer gives a lot of credit to his defensive coordinator, Mike Murphy, now in his second year with the Black Knights, and they're all on the same page. As the mids attack now, they do not see Derek between the pipes, rather still the freshman, 20-year-old Adam Fullerton.
Lucky for Fullerton that he's been put in a situation where he has to go into the game cold. He's not worried. He's been in these type of situations where he's sucked in. He's now got to step up and play. Most freshman goalies in the Army-Navy game have not had much success.
Well, he anticipated that first shot quite well, and then we saw him do what he does best. His stick skills are excellent. He put a BB out there as an outlet pass.
The thing that the Navy attack needs to realize is that Fullerton's a left-handed goalie. Obviously, they've been going over this in their scouting reports, but now they need to adjust what they've been doing all game long.
Freshman left-handed goalies. Princeton's got one of those, a real good one, named Alex Hewitt. I saw Georgetown get its freshman into a game and get a win over Mount St. Mary's. Miles Cass started and won for the Hoyas, although they have some concern with Ren Garnett, one of their big boppers on defense who's been ailing. Navy and Army today with you on CSTV. Russell makes a splendid stop there as it was John Burton turning the corner and nearly getting one back. Seven saves now for Matt, and perhaps none better than that last one.
Here comes John Burton, making his way to goal, does a nice job of switching hands, but Russell stops him. Great save.
30-second extra man situation now for Jack Emmer and the Cadets, trailing by four.
Huge possession for Army. Like we've said before, they need to convert. When they are up, they need to score.
Set play from Walker over the top, and that one is blistered wide by Chris Larson. Walker looking to draw a lot of attention away from the mids up the top.
And he does. When Walker has a ball, all eyes are on him, which opens up opportunities for the rest of the attackmen on the field. It's a great job. He did a nice job of skipping the ball. They just need to run the same play again, get the ball open person. Great.
And they do it right on cue, Sheehan, with Olbringer firing. And Matt Russell is starting to see the ball very, very well. He's locked in.
Great skip pass right out the Navy playbook. However, Army wasn't able to convert on that one.
The extra man situation now expired. We're back to even 6-on-6. Walker and the Knights dressed in black today. Walker with an advantage. He scores! John Walker found a seam.
We talked about the Navy step up. He just did. Walker is so good. Hendler's been containing him and doing a nice job of keeping him outside, letting him carry the ball, but not getting him a pass. Hendler did a good job keeping out, although Walker brought him down to goal line extended, then cuts back, does a little inside roll, and then is able to fire the ball. You can see he's coming down, great checks, good, looks like he's almost contained him. Actually, no inside roll, just goes right inside, and he gets handled while he gets to the goal line. But I'm telling you, it counts in an Army-Navy game, that doesn't hurt.
No fear as Clipper Lennon destroyed him there. Matt Russell has been beaten back to back. Larson and Walker on the board. It's suddenly 11-8 for Navy. And Bizzolo pops the faceoff loose.
Huge faceoff, great possession.
No fast break. They'll settle with Ben Harrell.
Which is smart. They're still down three goals. They need to make good possessions. You don't want to turn the ball over on a quick possession like this because Navy can answer. We've seen them. They've been scoring quick goals. Army needs to make the right decisions.
Go back to the hot hand. Go back to Walker. This is a guy who's fourth in the nation in terms of points per game. He averages better than four per contest. Wagner will put it out there wide. Walker leaves it in the capable hands. Coming from the alley. Chris Larson again, matched by Steve Looney. The inside roll, Larson stays with it. Dinola again, doubled beautifully.
Dinola's got that great defense. offensive mind. He sees the play before it's happening, is able to slide and then cause a double team and turnover. Great job.
Seth Danola, the senior Navy captain, was very, very close friends with a former Army standout, Jeff Bryan, who graduated last season. These pressure-packed Army-Navy games, all the bragging rights on the line again for these two. Navy in white. Along with Sheehan Stanwyck, I'm Joe Beninati. Glad you've tuned in on CSTV. That's Billy Looney in control. Navy, a slim leader after one half of play. Explosive third quarter, giving them a healthy advantage, but now Army is fighting back. That jump shot, score! Bill Looney to the offside.
Bill Looney, great job of moving around, makes a little arc, and then just fires it. It was a great job of moving the defense, actually moving Fullerton, and then fires to his right-hand side, because Fullerton's a left-hand goalie. He mixed up the shot, and it went in.
Billy Looney had four against Holy Cross earlier in the year. This is his third.
Great job. He just took the ball right off the catch, keeps moving, doesn't stop his feet, takes it on the run, comes in, fires it in. Completely, very tough saves for Fulton to make. Watch his stick, has to go completely over to the opposite side, tries to get his foot there, Fulton unsuccessful.
There are many who would say that Looney, Bill Looney, is the best natural athlete of the trio, Brendan, Steve, and Billy. Showing off some of that athleticism there to give Navy its four-goal bulge back. 9 minutes to go in regulation. Navy needs to win to prevent Army from winning the Patriot League. Navy still has the chance of hosting the Patriot League tournament right here. Fullerton makes the stop on Wallen. The carom controlled by Bersner. A real vacuum in the ground balls. Navy maintains possession with Graham Gill. It's been a good day for 40 in the white, Nick Mirabito. Now you would imagine the midshipmen try to drain the clock time, don't they?
The clock is their friend. Up by four, they just need to take control to get possession. Work the ball around. You got to shoot when the opportunity presents itself, but you don't need to force anything at this time of the game when they have this lead.
Black Knights press out man-to-man, hoping for a strip, hoping for a takeaway.
You put the pressure on Army's defense. Make them make the play. You want them to run at you, make them make the mistake, and then you can take advantage of it. Right now, Navy is in control. Army needs to make the big save, the big stop, and come up with the big check. Navy can just sit there and wait for Army to make a mistake.
Tori Sokol almost did it moments ago. Almost got Army away to the races. Billy Looney under control. Got past Jeff Auer. Andrew Yukulis was there to double. Gill took his eyes off it, and now the Black Knights have the ball. Sokol with the long pole. Crunched! Tommy Wallen threw a perfect shoulder check at him. This is going to be Army ball on the push. Richie Mead surveying from the sideline, watching the physical nature of this game ramp up with just 7.5 to go. Walker. Nice pass there, right on target for Jake Couch. Chris Larson. For that precocious freshman again, Matt Shield. And keep an eye on him. Very clever finisher, has had a way of scoring some big goals. Jack Emmer said he's played better than we had any right to imagine in his first year. Walker, left-handed and wide. John Walker has the ability to separate himself from defenders so easily.
His quickness just really puts him a level above. He's able to do these foot movements that just leave defenders behind him. Just a quick little shuffle of his feet, and he gets a step, and all he needs is one step to be able to get the shot off.
Mitch Handler, the man who's been covering him all day, says he never stops, he never quits. Pretty much the motto between these two teams.
Very tough pass by Army. You can't, when Navy's defense is so aggressive, you can't just fire it in the middle and hope someone's gonna catch it. It needs to be the right pass, the right opportunity. Army at this point, with 6 minutes to go, cannot lose any opportunities to score.
Bersner and Mirabito, the wise quarterbacks on this team, they know to slow it down again, hovering around the 6 minute mark, 12-8 for Navy. Winners of seven in a row over their nemesis from West Point.
Plenty of time left. We've seen Navy score goals in a matter of seconds back to back. It can be done. Navy just needs to take control. Right now, they have the ball in possession. You can see Army's defense stepping up the aggressive nature.
On the move for the mids, it's Cody Shea. Bersner back behind. Navy going deeper into the midfield rotations. This 22-year-old junior, Cody Shea, an outstanding Long Island high school prospect, or product, I should say, from Sachem. Bersner played catch with Maravito.
Great job by Navy. They're spreading it out, not letting anyone get double-teamed, moving the ball, wasting time on the clock, which is the goal.
Cody Shea. Watching this ball leave the box and go back over to Army. Time's a wasted now for the Cadets. Little over 5 minutes to go from Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium in the fourth. John Burton with the ball. Brother Mike is a Colgate grad. We've seen Burton get free a couple of times in this fourth quarter. Shield angling in. Been a solid afternoon for Andrew Dow defending him. Chris Couch ready to move. Navy's had the ball
Chris
a few minutes longer.
Trying to take advantage of being matched up with a short stick.
Nice pass inside. It caught Burton by surprise.
Not able to handle that one, but it was a great idea. He was wide open in the center. You got to do that.
Felger on the sideline was knocked out of bounds. This goes back to Army. Great hustle, though, by the long stick defender, Felber.
Lucky second chance for Army. 4 minutes to go. Army needs to score. They're down by four. Once Navy gets possession again, they're going to try to lose the clock. Army needs to have control, win the faceoffs, get the scores, keep the ground balls, and ultimately get it in the back of the net.
High-scoring Jim Wagner told us there's no need to reinforce how important this game is, and you can read it all over the players' faces now. 4 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Navy in control, but for how long?
This presentation of NCAA Lacrosse on CSTV is brought to you in part by Lax World. Visit the lacrosse section on CSTV.com to vote for the Lax World Hit of the Week. Lax World, all the gear, all the time.
There are two different roads to get to the 2005 NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships in Philadelphia. For fans, it's easy. For the teams, it's going to be just a little bit harder. For tickets, log on to faceoffphiladelphia.com. It doesn't matter how you get here, just get here.
CSTV.com congratulates our partner, the Baylor Bears, and their fans on an incredible season. You can relive all the excitement of this year's championship run at BaylorBears.com, the ultimate destination for Baylor Bear fans.
Got to be nail-biting time if you're an Army fan, trailing Navy by four on the road, just over 4 minutes to go. The two coaches in this battle of wits, Jack Emmer and Richie Mead, both of them very, very, very good friends. Jack Emmer, the longtime bench boss at the Military Academy, used to employ Richie Mead as one of his assistants in the early 90s. Those friendships are put aside for a couple of hours when these two teams clash on the lacrosse field. Walker and the Black Knights testing Matt Russell there, who kneels to deny. The quick flick just went wide, as that was Mike Obringer trying to get fancy at the top of the crease.
Matt Russell doesn't look like he has an ankle problem. Even Maryland's game, he was running all around. Still very quick reflexes, sees the ball go up, and he ran right after it.
Bang! Wagner zips one to the top corner, and Army's not finished yet.
Wagner's doing just what he needs to do, stepping up. His senior year, he's never beaten Navy before. This game is crucial, these last minutes. He needs to score. Great job. Fourth goal of the game. Wagner has stepped up today. They just need a little bit more out of him today if they want to still win. Great switch to the field. They're doing it great. Picture perfect plays. Good job by Walker making the whole defense switch, when you switch to field, everyone's off the step.
It's an Army team, Sheehan, that's been comfortable coming from behind in the last couple of big wins. They came from behind against Stony Brook. They came from behind against Bucknell, and now trying to do the same against Navy today with a little less than four to go in the fourth. The all-important draw. Vizzolo pushed it loose, and the ground ball belongs to Steve Looney. Pazzacco slugs it. Little one-touch passing from Horn to Bergner, and Bergner says, let's slow down.
Which we knew they were going to do. They have the clock on their side.
Navy has won 11 of its last 15 against ranked opponents, and they tangle with fourth-ranked Army right now. Gill keeping it on the wing. Billy Looney, who has three goals today and has played a brilliant game. Mirabito and Bersner connecting behind. Bersner sightseeing around that Army defense as they pack it in around the freshman netminder, Adam Fullerton, who's come on for the starter, Matt Darrick. Little less than three to go now.
Not a position you want to be in Army's defense. They need to make the play. They need the ball back. They need to start to double team. Looks like now they're beginning to do the slides. They need to force the outlet passes and then intercept.
Even strength here, 6-on-6. Horn will capture that. Jeff Auer pinching there defensively. Steve Looney just continues the slowdown game.
It's crucial that Army's defense isn't acting in panic mode, and they really need to. Right now, Navy's doing a nice job of just moving the ball around. Army needs the ball back. Defense needs to step up.
2:15 to go. With Navy in front by three. Trying to knock Army from the perch in the Patriot League. A win today for the midshipmen.
This is not where you want to be. With 2 minutes to go, you don't want the short stick on it. Good job of saying the long stick by Army, but it's too late.
And now it will be Navy asking for time. Richie Mead, John Tillman, the offensive coordinator, looking to diagram some strategy now with 1:57 to go. Adam Fullerton, you have to keep an eye on that crease. You would imagine before too long, Fullerton's going to be asked to come out and double the ball.
Definitely, probably sooner rather than later. Right now, Army needs the ball back. You can't just let Army, Navy pass around the perimeter and waste the clock go by. That's exactly what they want to do. You need to take them out of their element. You need to get the ball back.
So many of the games in this great series history separated by three goals or less. We've been talking about these two teams on the top rungs of the Patriot League, looking at the standings. It's been a marvelous year for Bucknell, and there's still a chance we could have a three-way tie for the Patriot League title.
The Patriot League just keeps getting better and better. Really one of the dominant conferences out there. Last year there was three teams in the NCAA tournament. They really stepped it up.
Bucknell beat Navy in overtime. Army beat Bucknell. Should Navy hold on and win over Jack Emmer's troops, that would help create that three-way tie scenario. In a three-way tie like that, Navy would have the advantage. In the baseball cap, that's John Tillman going over matters. And Army's defense has to break that huddle and get the ball. And do it quickly. You look at the win streak. Navy has tasted sweet success seven straight times. That 97 game in April was right here in Annapolis, the last time Army was victorious. These two teams say it's like looking in the mirror. Great mutual respect for what they have to do at the academies. Great mutual respect for what they are going to eventually have to do in protecting our great nation. And right now, focused on finishing up this Lacrosse 2005 skirmish.
Now we see the double team. They even got a check. That's what they need to do. They need to keep following the ball, collapse. We should have seen this about a minute earlier from Army.
As it's come loose for Fullerton. Ooh, he got a high hit delivered to him. Army has the ball. Leister rumbling ahead with it. The 230-pound defender. Leister drawing a crowd. Navy gets it right back with Felber. On to the captain, Danola. 80 seconds away now for Navy. Fast break, Mirabito just missed.
When they get the ball, they're sticking. They're that close to goal. They want to shoot. He does the right thing. He passes it off to Mirabito, who's been scoring, who knows how to put it in the cage. He misses, but Navy gets the ball back. Great job. He's coming down. He looks he wants to score, but gives Maravita the better opportunity. Misses, but Navy gets the ball right back.
Navy trying to continue to play its game of keep away. Andrew Yakulis, the 21-year-old junior, won't allow it. Now Fullerton comes out firing for Nick Dorr, a guy who barely saw the field the first few years at West Point, has had a fine senior campaign at defense. They need O right now, trailing by three with 50 ticks remaining. Danola around the ball again. Walker there. Just golfed on by Bersner. Leister will settle it. 40 seconds left in Navy's hopes. The nine-game win streak on the line.
Navy doesn't want to foul, just keep the ball out. Great job. Got Matt Russell with the ball. Now they just want to hold it. Navy doesn't want to shoot. You don't want to get the ball back into their possession.
That 70-yard pass may have been a little ill-advised, although Russell just wanted to relieve a little bit of the pressure.
I think it's Navy's ball.
Keep the ball on that half of the field if you are a Navy fan, protecting the three-goal advantage. On CSTV, down the stretch we go right now. Navy poised to pick up its ninth win of the season. Steve Looney challenged there by E.J. Barrett. We hear whistles. With holding against Navy, it's going to go back to Army. Not enough time now for the Black Knights, who have come from West Point on a major roll, but they see it end at Navy Marine Corps Stadium. Off the bench in jubilation, Navy continues its mastery of Army.
It was a close game in the first half, but Navy came out on fire right out of halftime. They pulled away, and Army was never able to claw back.
It was really all about that third quarter, Sheehan. Navy got settled into such a good groove, and it seemed like every shot they took found a corner on Matt Darrick.
That's right. In the beginning, in the first half, they struggled with their goal shots on goal and then their scores. But in the third quarter, those converted. We saw that great play, the skip pass, and a lot of scores.
Boy, Navy was just so good last year against top 10 teams. They get another big top 10 win today by the final of 12-9. Our Sirius Satellite Radio player of the game is midfielder Billy Looney.
Great game by Billy Looney, just a sophomore, really stepping up. Rookie of the year last year for the Patriot League. He just was able to fire hard, get in great positions, take the shots on the move. Really stepped it up, a great way to go in the Army-Navy game.
And he's getting a nice reputation of scoring the real big goals at the best times. Our Sirius Satellite Radio player of the game, Billy Looney. These two teams huddling up. Navy the victor by the final of 12-9. So things are shaping up well for Navy with respect to winning the Patriot League title. As we prepare now to let you enjoy something special, something specifically Army Navy's own, with the singing and the respectful recognition of the alma maters of these two schools. They'll go through the handshake line. Many of these players have worked against one another all the way through the prep school ranks. For many of these players, it's 4 years, and for those two guys, a great friendship can resume. Mac DeAnge, the assistant coach, was a high school, or rather a college teammate of Richie Meade long ago on Long Island in Nassau County.
There's definitely a lot of respect between these two teams. With all the field, they hate each other, and Navy's been able to walk off this field for now 8 straight years with smiles on their faces, something that this senior class Army has never been able to do for. Very unfortunate. You can just see the sadness. This is the biggest game of their season, and they have never had a win against Navy.
It's just Navy's second year in the Patriot League, and Army has ruled that Patriot League lacrosse with respect to a number of titles. They've won it, I believe, 8 times, the most of any of those member schools. But Navy is now in the driver's seat with this big win today over the arch rival Black Knights. And Matt Russell, when called upon in the second half, I thought he definitely ramped his play up.
He was a difference maker. He made the key saves that Coach Mee's been talking about. He really was explosive, stepped up his game, and really made Army fight for the shots they actually did have.
Matt was telling me, as you see the mark with respect to how they performed in conference play, Matt was telling me that this defense does all the talking for itself, that they do such a very good job of putting a force field around him and protecting him. And when he has to come up big, he has been more than ready to do so. As Navy prevails
by the final score of 12-9. They really blew things open in the third quarter and then hung on and staved off the challenge of Army. Now, the alma maters. From day to day, part of the Army alma mater. Just moments away now as these two teams will shuttle over in front of the Navy faithful. And we will hear on this beautiful Saturday afternoon, the Navy blue and gold.
I lost one.